So a UCL ligament is right here, right, right here. I put lotion on him so you can't see it. So a ligament injury is right here. So for usually the ligament is to hold, right? So this is the radial ligament on this side. It's always anatomical. So radial ulna, right? So this is the UCL ligament of the thumb, right? If they fall and they fall on an outstretched hand and they get pulled out like this, they can rip their ligament. So if they repair it, they're gonna repair it. And the key thing is that you cannot stress. So right, if it's a ligament and it's on this side, holding this joint together, you cannot stretch it in the opposite direction. So you cannot hold this bone and stress that ligament that way. So think about what you do that does that. A lot of pinching. Look at that. Look at my thumb, how weird it is. You pinch and you have weakness, it's gonna fall and it's gonna stress. Tip pinching stresses that ligament the most, right? Lateral pinch, three jaw chuck stretches it. Lateral pinch is probably the safest pinch, but you know, and then gripping. Any gripping is gonna put stress to that. So I always think about where the anatomical position is, what type of structure and what it needs to heal. And then if I do stuff with my hand, if I make a full fist really hard, it's gonna stress that ligament. If I do tip pinch, it's gonna stress that ligament. If I do three jaw chuck, it's gonna stretch that ligament. Lateral pinch is probably the safest pinch out of all of them, stresses it the least. 4 weeks out is usually when you're allowed to start moving those ligaments. So when they say active motion, it's active motion here, right? IP, you can do MP, you can do CMC. CMC motion is pretty much rotation, right? CMC motion is opposition, right? If you have a flat opposition, you're touching, but that's not true opposition. True opposition is nail to nail, right? Open, touch. Open extension is just as important as flexion. If you cannot extend, you cannot get into more opposition. If you cannot retropulsion, then you cannot get into more opposition. So you always have to open, touch, open, touch. Now, just because the ligament here was repaired, active motion of the thumb, you have thumb extensor muscles that travel through here, you have flexor muscles that travel through the wrist. So that means you have to do some wrist tenodesis. It's always the safest just to get active motion, right? You can do lateral, like just like we did. So this is gonna stress. It's not gonna stress it, but it's gonna make the muscles move. So you can do active. You're not gonna pull on it, because if you pull on it, it's gonna pull on that ligament, right? So you're not gonna pull on it. You can just do active though. So think about all the ways you move the CMC, which sits on the wrist. How can you actively move the MP and the PIP? And by stretching, they're saying that you're technically allowed to move the wrist, right? And then you can even move the thumb as long as you're not doing a ton of like passive aggressive stretching. Right? You always, with a ligament repair, have to remember their pain limits. They came in for surgery because they have pain and instability. So when you're doing exercises and activities, you always want to make sure that you're not causing pain and causing more instability in that thumb. And that's how you educate your patients. The reason why you have the surgery, because of pain and instability. Without the stability, the thumb can't work. And the thumb is 50% of your hand. When you grab and you don't have stability here, the finger, imagine, kind of falls off and it's painful. So if you have the surgery, don't mess up the surgery. Respect the pain. Respect that you have to gain your motion slowly, right? The passive that you're allowed to do is at the IP. But you see how I'm supporting it. You see my fingers are wrapped around that MP and I'm supporting it. And I can passively stretch the IP to make sure that that joint moves. And then I can passively stretch the CMC and I can passively stretch the wrist, right? But here, at the MP, I'm not gonna stress that ligament yet. Usually it's about 6 weeks, if I'm remembering correctly. You wanna get active motion first. You want it to be real nice and stable and less painful. And then you can start to pressure on it, and then you can start to strengthen. With this, your strengthening has to be done in a pain-free range. So you cannot start pinching and stuff when it's painful. You can do functional stuff like pegs, marbles, picking up things. But really, when you start working on it, make sure you can move the metacarpal. Remember that metacarpal rotates, right? Remember the skin has to give. So a lot of times the scar is here, and I will do this to mobilize. You see how tight he is, like here? The scar here, right? You're gonna have your people have scars. So remember, you can move them in different ways. So sometimes I'll get my hand like this, I'll go in between the thumb. My thumb sits in between the first metacarpal and the second metacarpal, and I can just gently pull. It feels good, right?
Yeah. Yeah.
This one always feels good. Why not make them feel good? Yeah. Right. So yeah. So I know that goes against your, you know, idea of like edema massage and stuff, but this is scar management. Right. So there's two different things. You want to do edema? Do edema. You do scar, it might look a little different.
Hey therapy friends, it's Huang here. Thanks again for watching my video. And if you like videos like this that can help you just crush it in the hand therapy world as an occupational therapist, then hit the subscribe button and enjoy the video. Thanks again for watching.